Let's talk about the coefficient of mutual inductance. Chapter 13, yep. The coefficient of mutual inductance. Now, you probably done this when you were young. You took a battery. I don't know why I made the battery so big. You took a nail here. And you take the wire and you wrap it around the nail. And you attach it there. What happens to that nail?
Magnetized.
That nail becomes a magnet, exactly.
It doesn't get hot
anymore. It will get hot. Well, actually, if you hold it like this, it does get hot. If you take a wire and you attach it right there, even a small one for a while, you wait about 10 seconds, ouch, and you'll feel it actually burn your hand there. Yeah. So this becomes a magnet. Well, why it becomes a magnet? Now, there's something, and when we get to in physics, you'll cover that, something called the flux. I don't know if you cover the flux there, magnetic coupled circuit.
I know we went over electric flux.
But basically what you have to know is, when you have an inductor here, let's take a picture of a source called I sub S, I don't know. You have an inductor here. If you grab another inductor called L1 here, if you grab another inductor right next to that, you attach it next to it, it depends how far from it and how big L1, L2. What's going to happen is actually this will feel the effect of that. Will be current going through that. Why? Because you're in the neighborhood of this field here. And if that inductor is close to that, we're going to have what we call mutual inductance. So mutual inductance we use the letter M here with the effect of M onto from 1, the result of this here coming from 1, and we found out actually there's a voltage here. If you measure that voltage here, now, if you remember, for an inductor, what was the voltage? The voltage for an inductor is what? If this is L, V equals L di dt, right? Well, the value here of this voltage here, it's going to be, it's not going to be L1, it's not going to be L2, it's going to be a different value. It's called M, mutual inductance. We need to figure out what that number is. Time is the derivative of the current through 1. So that current going through that, the derivative of that times the mutual inductance. Now, what is the mutual inductance? So a lot of times, instead of M21 to 1 or M2 to 1, we call it M1 to 2. We just use the letter M instead of 2M and M2 and all that. And the question also becomes, is it positive or is it negative? And that will take us to something called the dot convention. And we'll talk about the dot convention. Now, the value of M will change. It depends how far L1 from L2. If they're too far from each other, the value is 0. Usually, the value of M is less than or equal to the square root of L1 times L2. It's between 0 and that number. If it's too far, there's no mutual inductance. Like, for example, if you go back to this, but you make the loop really, really big, and the nail is in the middle, you won't feel it. That does not become a magnet. You become close to that, you'll see the magnet here. The same thing, if these two inductors far away from each other, the mutual inductance, the value between them is 0. If they're very close, where all these flux, all these wires, waves going through it, it's almost the square root of that value. So somewhere between these two numbers. So let's look at the dot convention. How do we do? Do we add them or do we subtract them? What's going on? So let's explain that. Let's take this example. This is L1. I'm going to put the dot here on the top. And let's say the current going through that. This is I1. It's going to mark this inductor plus to minus, right? Now, let's take this one. We'll call that V2. So this is V1. And let me put the dot for this right here. And there's a mutual inductance between them called M. Let me talk about the dot convention. This is what our book says. I don't know if you can see it. I'll read that to you. A current entering the dotted terminal of one coil produces an open circuit voltage with the positive voltage reference at the dotted terminal of the second coil. We have a current. Let's look at this example. A current entering the dotted terminal. This current entering the dot produces an open voltage. There'll be a voltage here with the positive voltage of this one where the dot is. Notice the current entering the dot. That means the dot here is positive, down here is negative. So this dot and that dot will have the same polarity, meaning the dot here will be positive just like this one. On the other hand, a current entering the undotted, if the current was coming this way, be a plus here, minus there. So the dot is minus here. It says, a current entering the undotted terminal of one coil produce a voltage that is positively sensed to the undotted terminal of the second voltage. So if the current enters this way, this is plus, minus, the dot is minus, that means this dot will be minus and this will be a plus here too. That's the effect of this current coming down on that one. So let's take a few examples with that. Again, here, what's V2 is going to be? It's going to be the mutual inductance times the change in this current. And the question, is it positive or negative? And there's how we answer it. The current comes in. I jumped the gun with this. I already put the plus and minus. Let me take the plus and the minus out here. Let's say I define V2 to be plus minus here. And tell me what is V2 equal to. Here's what's going to happen. The current enters the dot. The current traveling this way is going to mark the voltage here plus to minus. The dot going to have the same polarity. That means the effective mutual inductance, the dot here will be positive to match this one and minus down here. And that happens to be the same direction as V2. So that's why V2 is positive M times DI1 DT.
Wait, so the dot matches the dot of the other?
Correct. The sign of the dot to the mutual inductance will match that one. That's why it's called.
L2 had a dot like at the bottom.
Well, I'm going to give you that actually. David, here it comes. I'm going to give you different scenarios. This is L1, there's the dot. And the question that Dave about to ask and Joe, they said, what about the dot here? Right? And let's say I define this voltage plus to minus V2 here. This is the mutual inductance between them. And the current going this way. So this current is going to come down, is going to mark the dot what? Positive, this end minus. So what's going to happen? The effect, the mutual inductance on this side, the dot will have to have the same polarity. If the dot is plus here, the dot will be what?
Plus there.
Plus here, minus there. Look at V2 and look at this. Are they in the same direction? No. So V2 is going to be minus M DI1 DT. Okay. What about if the current doesn't enter the dot? Let's look at that option. This is L1 in the dot here, and I sub 1 is going this way. Again, this is the mutual inductance here. And let's say the dot is actually here for this example. And this is V2. I define V2 that way. So what is V2 equal to? Let's watch that. I sub 1 is going to travel this way. It's going to mark it plus to minus. So the dot here is what? Negative. So this will be a minus plus. So what is V2 in relation to the mutual inductance here, the value? Negative M DI1 DT. And the last option, I'll do it, and that covers all of them. Here's the dot. This is L1. This is I sub 1. This is V2. Let's say the dot is here, and this is L2. Mutual inductance again here. What is V2 here is going to be? Let's see. The current comes down. Plus, minus. That means the dot is going to be what? Minus. It's going to be minus here, which means plus here. Look at the relationship of these two. Are they in the same direction? Yes. So V2 is going to be positive M DI1 DT. Correct. Figuring out which way is going. So how do we use that? Now let's take an example. And see if we can solve it.
Before then, we were just like doing circuits. We didn't care like where like each component.
Yeah, we assumed they were too far from each other. Now we're going to say they might be close, and they'll know if they're close. They'll put the dot to let you know there's mutual inductance.
Will it give us
the value of M? Yes. We can also measure them in the lab.
So when you yeah. go in circuits, you want like a certain range?
Well, it depends what you're looking for. You'll see that soon enough we'll talk about something called ideal transformer. What actually determines the value here, it's not just how far from each other. When you make the inductors, turns, how many turns do you do there? You put on each one. The number of turns will determine the value.
Okay.
Yep, for ideal, we'll talk about ideal transformer. And you'll see, we said the ratio of V1 to V2 really depends on N1, N2, how many turns on this, how many turns on that one. So let's take an example to use these. I have a voltage source of the value of 10 cosine 10t. And it's going on the top here. We have 1 ohm resistor. That's an inductor. I don't know if you can see. That's an inductor of 1 henry. And the dot here. Another inductor here of 100 henry, the value is 400 ohms, and we're saying, what's the voltage rise here, V2? Can we find what V2 is? And I'm going to give you the mutual inductance, which I didn't write yet. So the mutual inductance between these two is 9 Henry.
So it's 1 Henry and 100 Henry.
Yep, and you got a 9 Henry up on the top, mutual inductance. Mm-hmm. Well, let's change it to a phasor first. This is 10 angle 0. One. What's W here? 10, right? So J omega W, Z for the inductor is what? J omega L. So omega is 10. Times L. You tell me what L, I'll tell you what the value. This is 1, that'll be times 10, that's 10J. This is, L is 100, 100 times 10, that's what? 1000J? The mutual inductance, 9, 9 times 10 is what? 90J. And the resistor is 400. And we're looking for V2. And we can still do what we did before, assign current, UKCL, assign current going through this.
Do you want them going the same way or do you want the current?
Doesn't matter. Doesn't really matter. I always make them the same direction, I always do that. Now we have to be careful. Let's do KVL right here. KVL on the left side. I'm saying there's a current going this way and there's a current going that way. I assign them in that direction.
Oh, right, they are going.
So let's see what will happen. KVL in this loop says what? Negative 10. Plus the voltage drop here, which is what? 1 times I sub 1. Plus the voltage drop through this. If this wasn't here, what's the voltage drop here? Isn't that this times that? 10J times I sub 1. But I'm not done. Wait a minute. I'm looking at this side. There's current going through this. That current going through this is going to affect this one. It's going to be the mutual inductance, which is 90J, times that current, I sub 2.
Are you adding it to the...
Well, here's the question. Do we add it or do we subtract? I left it blank. Well, let's see what's going on. I sub 2 is traveling this way. Right?
Mm-hmm.
It's going to mark this plus, minus. So my dot here is what? Negative. So what's the effect of this current and the mutual inductance on this? Going to mark it which way? Minus to plus, so that'll be a subtraction.
Because it's going positive.
It's going this way.
Yeah.
So now I can rewrite that equation. Go 1 plus 10J times I sub 1. Minus 90J I sub 2 equals 10 angle 0.
Oh, so you don't do VT.
Well, you can, but when we would do it in phasor, that's the equivalent of that in phasor. If I was doing time domain, yep, I would do DIDT and solve in time domain. But in phasor, we know that becomes J omega L. Impedance times the current through. We treat them just like a resistor, you know, an impedance. What about KVL on the right side? Let's look at the right side. So let's do KVL right here. What do we have? Don't pay attention to this. you have 0, there's no source there, right? Equals 400 I sub 2 plus 1000 J If this wasn't here, it was too far away, that's what you have. Equals 0. But there's going to be effect here from this one. And let's see what that effect, let's see, actually, let me erase now these here and see what's going on. The polarity. I sub 1 is traveling down this way. So it's going to be 90J I sub 1. That's the effect of mutual inductance. It's the 90J times that value, the current. Now I sub 1 is coming down, it's going to mark the dot positive. Is this going to be what? Negative. So my dot is going to be positive here, and this is negative. I was traveling this way, so I'm entering which side now? Negative, that's a minus. Clean that equation, and what do you have? 90J, I took, moved everything to that side. I'll make this a minus. Minus what? 400, oh, I forgot to write I sub 1. Minus 400 plus 1000 J, I sub 2 is equal to 0. That's equation 2. So now I have two equations by two unknowns. I'll take the two equations and solve them mathematically. Oh, one is one. No, that's a one, the first one. Equation one, equation two. One is one, one is two. So you have two equations by two unknowns. So we solve them any method you want to. You can use determinant if you want to. You can use graphing calculators if you have one. And the other one, 90J times I sub 1 minus 400 plus 1000J I sub 2 is equal to 0. So I'll go to my TI-86, has simultaneous on it. I like that button here. Where is simultaneous? There we go. Two equations by two unknowns. Plug them in. The coefficient of the first one, 1 comma 10. The second one, negative 90J, so 0 comma negative 90. The next one, the answer is 10 angle 0. The next one, 90J, 0 comma 90. The next one, negative 400 comma negative 1000. And the answer is 0. And let's solve it. And if my enter the values correctly, I sub 1 is going to equal 2.06 angle negative 38.5 degrees. I sub 2 is going to equal 2.172 angle what? Negative 16.7. Now, if I know I sub 2, the question, what is V out? Can I find V out? I define V out plus to minus here. So what is V out? Isn't that 400 I sub 2? So take that, multiply them. Get out of this here, quit. 400 times I sub 2, which is 0.172 angle negative 16.7. That's 68.8 angle negative 16.7. let's try another one. Make it a little more challenging. 20.
Three inductors.
Well,
I don't know why, but I'm not sure if you're wrong. I'm saying I'm probably wrong, but I'm getting like 0.105294.
I can tell the answer matches, so.
48. I don't know, it's weird.
So, Joe, you got a mistake there. Let's take another one. This one, we're not going to solve it, we're just going to set it up. Five ohms, an inductor here. Of 7 Henry. There's the dot. There's a capacitor here of 1 farad. There's another inductor here. The dot is down here. Of 6 Henry, and there is a 3 ohm resistor. We do encounter one with 3 of them there too.
Wait, so we're doing this stuff, like how close are we assuming them to usually?
Well, the mutual inductance for this problem is given to us to be 2 Henry. Listen, these two guys not too far from each other, they feel it. 2 Henry. Now I'm going to change that to phasor, and the source will be, this is lowercase v, so when you change it to a phasor, whatever the value becomes Vs, capital V. Whatever the, we're not sure what the value, so I can't tell you what that is. So some number in phasor. The resistor stays the same. This is what, J omega L? We have no idea what omega is. So this becomes J omega L. L is 7, J 7W. The capacitor. 1 over J omega C. 1 over J omega C. C is 1. 1 over J W. C is 1. The inductor here. J omega L. L is 6. And the mutual inductance here, J omega M, or L here, that's 2W. This is actually going to be challenging. Doesn't look that bad, but it is challenging. This is I sub 1. This is I sub 2, and this is I sub 3. KVL at I1, we'll go loop 1, whatever, right here, you know, right there. Again, if I don't have any mutual inductance, if I have none, how would you write that equation? Neglect these dots, don't even see them. What would you write there?
Negative Vs.
Negative Vs, good. plus 5 I sub 1
plus I1 minus I2
times I1 times minus I sub 2 times the impedance, which is what? J7W times this one. And you're done, but not here. Why? Because this one is feeling the effect of that one. So let's decide on what direction you want the current to go, because if you'd make the current coming down here, that becomes what? I sub 2 minus I sub 3. If you use the current up, that becomes what? I sub 3 minus I sub 2. So which way you want it? Doesn't make a difference.
I sub 2 minus I sub 3.
So you want it down. So this current here down, there's a mutual inductance now, let's leave it, which is what? J2W times the current down, that's I sub 2 minus I sub 3. And all of that equal to zero. And I left a space there for the sign. It's either going to be a plus or a minus. So what's going to happen? The current comes down, marks a plus, minus. So my dot now is what?
Minus.
So the effect on this, minus to plus. So that'll make it what?
A negative.
And that's my first equation. I'm sure you can clean it. I won't clean it. I'll leave it for you. I'll let you have fun with it. It's not really that difficult to clean. I mean, I could clean it. Vs equals, what is I sub 1? 5 plus J7W. What's I sub 2? Negative J7W minus J2W. Is that negative 9? JW I sub 2 or negative J9W I sub 2 is the same thing. What about I sub 3? Is that a positive? J2W I sub 3. That's equation number one. Now let's look at equation. Let me bypass two and let's go to three. I'll come back to two later. Let's go to three. KCL at I sub 3. That's right here. Again, don't worry about the mutual inductance. I'm going to erase the plus minus here. Gone. No mutual inductance yet. Let's do a loop right here. So what do we have? 3i sub 3 plus j6w I sub, well, what's the current?
I sub 3
minus I sub 2. I'm traveling this way, plus minus, right? I'm going this way. Now let's look at the mutual inductance. We're talking about this. This one's going to affect them. Which way you want the current, down? If I do the current down, there's a mutual inductance, which is what? J2W times the current down, which is I sub 1 minus I sub 2. Now what's going to happen? This current's going to come down, it's going to mark the dot what? Positive, negative. What's the effect going to be? The dot is positive. What's the dot going to be here? You mean positive on the bottom, negative on the top. Is that what you meant?
Yep. Yeah,
so notice that's the same direction as going this way, right? So that becomes what, this value?
Positive.
It's the same way I was going. So that's my equation number two, or three, whatever. I'll come back and do the middle one. Clean that. I have 2JW I sub 1. I sub 2, I got negative 6 minus 2, is that negative 8? And what about I sub 3? 3 plus J6W, I sub 3 is equal to 0. And that's equation number 2, or 3, whatever, the third loop, how's that? Now the middle one, I left it for a reason, and you'll see. Here's the middle one.
Sorry, can you put that back for a second? I messed up writing the equation.
No problem, I could clean this anyway. Okay. Now the middle one, the fun one. KCL. Did I say KCL or KVL? I believe KVL. KVL, not KCL. Some of the voltage. KVL at I sub 2, the middle one. Again, let's look at if I don't have any mutual inductance. I'm traveling this way, so I'm marking everything what? Plus, minus, plus, to minus, right? I'm going this way. So I'll begin with the top, the capacitor. 1 over JW times I sub 2 plus 6J or J6W times the current down, I'm going this way. That's I sub 2 minus I sub 3. Continue plus J7W times what? What's the current up? I sub 2 minus I sub 1. So if I don't have mutual inductance, I'm done. Right there. Here's my problem. When I'm looking at this one, I got to also include the effect of this. So let's look at the effect of this when I'm looking at that one. So I'm going to use the current coming down. So that would be the mutual inductance, which is J2W. And the current down is what? I sub 1 minus I sub 2. So I'm looking at the effect of this on this one. Now again, let's monitor that. Let me use a different color. I'll use red. It's going to mark it plus to minus, right? That means the dot here becomes what? Plus, minus, so I gotta subtract that. When I'm looking at this too, when I'm looking at this one here, I gotta include the mutual inductance of that one. So again, J2W, let's use the current down, that's what? I sub 2 minus I sub 3. So let's see what's going on there with I sub 2 minus I sub 3. Where's my whiteout? It's nice to have whiteout, lots of it. So this one is going to come down this way, is going to mark it plus to minus. So my dot will be what? Negative. This dot will be negative, this will be positive. And what's going on? Positive. That's equal to 0. And now we just got to clean that. So when I'm looking at this, I got to find the voltage due to current going through it, plus the mutual inductance of that on this. When I'm looking at this, I got to figure out the voltage due to that inductor and the current going through it, also the effect of this one on it. And now I can clean this one more time. I sub 1, there's only one I sub 1, right? negative. Where is it? Oh, yeah, right there. So negative 7 and negative 2 is at negative 9.
Is that positive 7?
Plus. Oh, no, because it's minus.
Negative,
7.
That's a minus there. Let's see I sub 2. We get 2. I sub 2. Minus the, that's plus 2, right? Mm-hmm. Minus and minus, that's plus. That's 4j.
And then plus
7j. 4 plus 7 is 11. 11 plus 6 is what? 17 plus that number. So plus J17W plus 1 over JW I sub 2.
Well, do you want to just get rid of all the W terms?
I could multiply by W, you mean? Not yet. Looks like something funny there. It doesn't look like a W. That's a W now. Now what about I sub 3? That's negative 6. Negative 2, that's a negative 8. Looks like that's it. Minus J. J what? 8 W I sub 3.
Equals 0,
yeah. We couldn't cancel them even if we tried here too. I was looking at the other equations here. Notice this does not have a W there. I know what Dave was thinking. If everyone has W's, divide by W. Unfortunately, the 5 doesn't, and this doesn't. Same thing right here. The 3 doesn't. If they did, just divide by W. It's gone. Make it look cleaner. Same story right here. I got that W in the bottom. But what I could do is multiply by W to get rid of that W and make that W squared. Set it up because we have no numbers. Just write that way. If they have numbers, it won't be that bad. You know? Because that's a negative J over W. So if you really had numbers, what W is, this would just be a decimal value or a fraction. But that's where the trick to this, when you're looking at this, you gotta look at the effect of that on it too. When you're looking at this, you gotta look at the effect of that, the mutual inductance on it. And when you're doing the middle one, it gets ugly. That's why I waited on that one till the end.